Good morning. It's Thursday, April 11th, 2013. My name's Stephen Whiteside, and I'm your host this morning for today's edition of Stock Market Timing Television. Coming up to 9 a.m. on the East Coast, and stock index futures are flat, so we are looking for a quiet open Thursday morning at 9:30. Dealing with a bit of a head cold here this morning, running a little behind, just going to do one video for both markets. The headline, of course, Dow S&P 500 making new all-time highs yesterday. Big day yesterday for the NASDAQ, and some of that's going to unwind at the open this morning. So the NASDAQ is back on a buy signal. News out about a report stating that PC sales had fallen the most in history, and that's not good for some of the technology companies. The Canadian stock market, we saw a couple of buy signals for a couple of the indexes we follow yesterday, but the TSX is still on a sell signal. Overnight, we saw some buying in Australia, which is back on a buy signal. We saw some buying in Hong Kong. Coming into the close, it moved right down near the bottom of the day. And a little selling in Shanghai, some buying in Tokyo, and the yen continued to move lower overnight. Next up, let's take a look at commodity prices, and no changes in the futures I follow on a daily basis. Light crude moved up yesterday, still on a sell signal. No change in trend for gasoline, for heating oil, or for natural gas, still holding a buy signal there. No change in the metals I follow on a daily basis. Copper, after having the big up day, had an inside day yesterday. Gold had a big down day yesterday, now back below the channel once again. Inside day for silver on Wednesday, so no change there. Looking at our piece of the puzzle, we saw a lot of buying in the North American stock market yesterday. Bonds sold off, still on a buy signal here, but certainly bonds going lower is supportive for higher stock prices. The U.S. dollar was actually up on the day, and that's negative for stocks. Euro was down on the day. That's usually negative for stocks. So we're seeing some divergences here. You'll also see a divergence in the VIX in a few minutes. Looking at the Dow, it made an all-time high yesterday. Traded above our resistance target we talked about yesterday, but traded through it and did not have a clean break above it. So we're still attached to that previous resistance. If we can break away, and that is a breakaway is where you have the low of the day above resistance, then we're heading to 15,000, which is both a daily and weekly price target for the Dow. Looking at the Russell, it was up sharply yesterday, as was the ZAX. So you've got a vast majority of the major indexes in the U.S. back on buy signals. With bank stocks, the previous day had a buy signal. Nice big update for the semiconductors yesterday. Some of that's going to unwind this morning with the news about PC sales. Transports were up there, back on a buy signal. Probably the worst performing sector was golds yesterday, and the XAU had an inside day and closed lower on the day on Wednesday. Taking a look at the Canadian market, TSX drove into the channel yesterday. New buy signal for the energy sector, and I have a new buy signal for my energy stock this morning. No change for financial services, traded up into the channel yesterday. No change for gold stocks, for materials, for metals and mining. Had that buy signal the previous day. Didn't get anywhere on Wednesday. Telecom stocks back on a buy signal as of Wednesday's close. And the venture exchange closed lower on the day on Wednesday. Take a look at my five U.S. stocks, and while the NASDAQ had a runaway day yesterday, it wasn't really helped by Apple Computer, still on a sell signal. No change for the CME Group, no change for Google. The stocks that helped the NASDAQ yesterday, Microsoft, Intel, had a lot more to do with what happened in with the NASDAQ than Google and Apple did, which is kind of odd. We have a new buy signal for Goldman Sachs. We got rid of half of our position in Goldman Sachs at 143.75, and so now we need to cover the rest of our short position this morning and go long Goldman Sachs. And Visa, no change there, still on a buy signal. Couple stocks in the news this morning. Hewlett Packard's trading lower, Intel's trading lower, and Microsoft is trading lower this morning, all on news regarding PC sales. Take a look at my six Canadian stocks, starting with Agrium. Inside day yesterday, closed lower. No change for Bank of Montreal. Did trade up to the upper channel line, but did not close above it. We're on a new buy signal for Encana, for in Canada. We got rid of half of our short position at 1875. And took some money off the table. We were looking for a move down, but that didn't continue. And so now we need to cover the rest of that short position and go long in Canada at the open on Thursday morning. Goldcorp, no change there. No change for Lumina Copper. And WestJet finally broke out of the tight range it had been in for the last couple of days. And we traded down through the lower channel line, but did not close there. We need to close below 2453 to give us a new sell signal on Thursday. Last up, a couple of 60-minute charts. S&P 500 came off the bottom of the panic zones. Nice pressure zone there. Moved up, traded through an early warning signal. We ended Wednesday on an early warning signal. The VIX, which is now down towards the bottom of the panic zones with a pressure zone forming. Notice while the S&P 500 made a new high yesterday, the VIX did not make a new low. So not everybody's convinced that the market's going to continue to move higher. We want to remain bullish on the U.S. stock market as long as the VIX stays below 1287 on Thursday. And we want to be bullish on the stock market as long as the S&P 500 cash index stays above 1577.44. Looking at the NASDAQ, we'll remain bullish on the NASDAQ on Thursday as long as we don't start closing below 2831. And for the XAU, we're looking for an hourly close above 127.31 to give us a new intraday buy signal on Thursday. Looking at the Canadian stock market, came off the bottom of the panic zones, nice pressure zone, still projecting higher prices here, but we've run into resistance in the flypaper channel. We ran up to the 50-hour moving average on Tuesday, then we ran up to the 100-hour moving average on Wednesday. Still projecting higher prices here. There's certainly a chance we could run up to the 200-hour moving average, which is coming in line with previous support here. Of course, support on the way down is resistance on the way up. We're on an intraday buy signal for the Canadian stock market, and we'll remain bullish on the Canadian stock market on Thursday as long as we don't start closing below 12,499. The other side of the coin, of course, is volatility, and we'll remain bullish on the Canadian stock market on Thursday as long as the VIX does not start closing above 1421. That would certainly be a sign that options traders are starting to fear the market and looking for lower prices. Okay, folks, that's all for Thursday morning. On Friday, I may just post some web pages and not force you to listen to my cold-ridden voice. Have a great day, and I'll talk to you again next on Friday morning.